Hi, I am Manoj Kumar from INFLIBNET Center. This is a video tutorial for Urkund, the anti-plagiarism software, which has been subscribed by INFLIBNET Center through a global tender and provided to about 120 universities as on date. The universities which signed MOU with the INFLIBNET Center. As you are aware, Shodhganga is created as a repository of Indian theses and repositories by which all users can browse, search and download theses. The repository on open access will help to reduce plagiarism, since all the PhD theses are made available from the university who submitted it to INFLIBNET Center. Urkund is an anti-plagiarism software which is provided by eGalactis Pune to the universities on 1st August 2015 after the tender process and the selection of the product. So, this tutorial will help you to understand how Urkund can be used for checking the plagiarism in the articles, publications, thesis, dissertation, etc. The homepage of Urkund will give you a login prompt, and Urkund works as a web-based service. Through web pages, you can log in and submit the content into Urkund. About 45 billion web pages are scanned for checking the plagiarized content in Urkund. And another 1 year, the universities which signed MOU with the INFLIBNET Center will be getting the software. And I welcome you to see the tutorial on Urkund. When you click on the homepage www.urkund.com, you get the homepage of Urkund where there is a login prompt in the left side, and there are other options where you can read about plagiarism, etc. So let us see that how Urkund is used.
To use Urkund, you need a browser, because Urkund works as a web page. And any browser can be used for getting access to Urkund. A web page will be opened and you can enter your user and password. So I will be using either Internet Explorer or Chrome. You can use Google Chrome as shown here, Internet Explorer, Mozilla, Opera browser, Apple Safari, whatever. But only one thing you have to notice, that if you are using any of these browser, it should be a little upgraded version. Not pretty new is required, like Internet Explorer that was released in 2001, 10-13 years back. That is an outdated browser. So some of the features may not work. Otherwise, whatever browser which you are using now, that can be used for getting access to Urkund. Now, what is required? I opened the browser here. I type Urkund URL, that is the web address for Urkund, urkund.com, www.urkund.com. If you want to go directly to the login page, you can even put /en. So I just give Urkund. Now you got the home page of Urkund. Look at this. Full homepage. Now, in this homepage, you can see details about Urkund, and services, student support, contact, and order. But right now, we will restrict our plagiarism check with Urkund by login using and support for getting some of the help. Let me go to support first, because that is the things which you may require. Here you will see that how the Urkund can be used. All user guides and user manuals are given here. Even anything is missed out in my presentation, you can go here to check it. That is quick start guide, is there masterclass duplicate, admin guide is there, then handbook itself will give a lot of details. So now I click on this login. I mentioned home, login and support is what is required. If you are a student user, this can be. You can just browse down and read it. What is here, it gives the way. There are three ways it is mentioned, but this is in very general to get into Urkund. We will, may not be using it. We have a special mechanism for Indian universities to get into. Once you register, you automatically get an email once INFLIBNET recommended your name to Urkund. Now I clicked on Urkund login and I am entering one login name here. I can enter Manoj and at inflimnet.ac.name. You see here I can use username or email address. So I am using email address here. And I typed my password here. Now I am going to the Urkund. This is how Urkund dashboard look like. I have only uploaded one document on this folder, but I have uploaded many documents for checking when I was using a style. Here you can see that this, all these documents are checked. Result is not available because I was using it as a test. So I go to my first home page. Here you will see what are the things required here. Help is there. The simple button upload, nothing to worry about it. Just click and upload and upload your document. Urkund will generate a report and send you a mail. Even after a completion of the upload, it will send you a mail to your registered mail account. You can change your password here if it is required. Change password option is there. Then you can edit a little bit if you want to change to English, etc. But we are by default, I have changed to English. So I'm taking it. Now, logout is there. If you are on any of the screen, you can click Urkund logo to come back to the dashboard. This is what is dashboard. I don't have many documents here. So what I'll be using is, I'll take a document, Shodhganga account where documents are used. Here, you can log into the settings and enter your details. This I change to language English. Three options are here. The newsletter, if you subscribe it, you, they will keep on sending newsletter. You can disable it if you don't want. And report, send a report by mail. Include submitted document as attachment. And your document has to go to Urkund archive. That means once you submitted, that your document will part of the Urkund database. Next time somebody check the document or copied content from your own document, that will report that this is already submitted. And there is a filter here. This filter is used for Urkund to exclude that whatever you are giving here, they are giving an example like example.com. If you give it this site, example.com, if I give inflimnet.ac.in, then my website will not be checked against plagiarism content. That will be skipped. That is what is this. So this can be set for all the accounts if you want to check the account. For if you want to filter the document. And now let me try to log in with Shodhganga. Before that, how to get, you may have some questions. So I'll use a slide to before I log into the original account. You have already seen that I logged in. So the anti-plagiarism software is under the project called Shodhganga, which is the thesis repositories. Right now 41,000 theses are uploaded. And part of this plagiarism software is given by INFLIBNET Center, and you will see in the homepage itself Urkund anti-plagiarism software selected by INFLIBNET Center for university. This is the homepage of Shodhganga, which I have showed here, that where you will get all the details. You come right side of the panel, you will get the FAQ also. Now we have selected through a tender process, as I mentioned. And first onwards, you are getting the access on that. I will not discuss the detail about plagiarism, etc. There are a lot of material available. Even in Urkund itself, there is a Urkund plagiarism handbook. It's a good document to read about plagiarism. Now, Urkund is a completely automated system against plagiarism check. This is the home page which you have seen, which I made. I have to log in, etc. Now, how to create an account? This is the question. So there are two, three kinds of users. Generally, it's students, research scholar or faculty members or teachers, then an administrator. So right now in India, any university which sign MOU with InfliBNet, if they are eligible for getting funding from UGC, they will get a mail from noreply@urkund.ca. This is done by InfliBNet. We recommend your name, like we have recommended about 130 universities which signed MOU. These are the university name we recommended, and these are the email IDs which you are seeing here. Email IDs which will be created as an account in Urkund, and after that this ID can request for the other user. You can send the list of the user, then that will be created. This is how Urkund right now the account is created. Recommend your name, you get a mail telling that it will create an trial account. This is not trial. When I registered for trial, I got this. You will get an mail that your name dot your institute short form at analysis.urkund.com. We are InfliBNet, so we got INFL, Manoj INFL analyst. And there are two email IDs which are important for Urkund. One is your registered email ID. That is your original email ID. Manoj@inflimnet.ac.in. And the second one, Urkund creates an analysis email ID. This email ID is very important because any user who is having an account, they can enter this email ID so that report will come to my account and I can read it through my manoj@inflimnet.ac.in. In case of any help required for creation and all, you can contact me or Shodganga team or Nisha@egalactics@gmail.com, who provided the software. Now, there are many ways. Even there you will see that if Urkund can be integrated with LMS, which we have not done right now. LMS means whatever LMS you are using, Urkund can be used. If somebody is seriously looking for integration, then we may help you in future. But the other way is, as I mentioned, through email. And that will create an analysis account, then it will submit. And how to submit into Urkund? You can send your document to this address because this is treated as the faculty account. And the other one is that first time when you are successful, it will create the dashboard. The dashboard will have a button which I showed earlier, upload. So that upload, by using upload button, you can. And what are the file formats it supports? Almost all files, doc, Word file, OpenOffice file, PPTX, TXT, HTML, WPS, DocX, the latest version from Microsoft, PPT, PDF, and RTF, HTML, even the OpenOffice documents. All these documents can directly submit to Urkund for checking plagiarism. There is only one limit as far as the model is concerned. This is not a restriction for the user. If you are submitting any document, if it is less than 40,000, kindly check it. It is 4 lakh character, it will be considered as one document. If anything 4 lakh above, let us say 4 lakh and 1, that will be treated as two document. That means 8 lakh and 1 character would be treated as three document. And we have made this model based on the number of submission. So there is no submission limit, no university limit, no user limit, no department limit in Urkund, as far as this model is concerned. Now, how to log in? You have a login prompt, login button here. Click on that, and you get this is the login to Urkund system. Click here to log in, then you are through. Right side, this do not bother now. This is for the administrative purpose, which is not given to the university as on date. Now, Urkund also can be logged in with the a single sign-on program like Shibboleth, and this is also not used by InfliBNet. So we have the mechanism to log in with your username or email, as I mentioned, showed you Manoj@InfliBNet, and password. Faculty, university coordinator, administrator, all that can enter here password. And I request you that please do not share your password with anyone, because each document submitted by you is your document. Next time anybody check and the content is copied from the document, it will be shown that you are the original author, and you have to cite it in the if you are using it. That is the way Urkund or any anti-plagiarism software. So it's a good idea and appreciating idea that password should not be shared Urkund, unless essentially it has to be shared with someone. If it, the situation insists so, then student can create an account. If student want to check to faculty account, they need to create an account. Any user who is using Urkund has to register. So student can register with Urkund. After registration, they can use the faculty mail to send report. So report will directly go to faculty. So this is how I tried to use create an account for student account. I used my other email ID, the name, password, two times, and once it is so simple that using the interface you can submit it. This is the dashboard I was mentioning. This dashboard you can see that here, the your institute name with analysis email ID. Then you have new folder creation here, settings here, then upload document. These are the some of the things. And this area which is showing here is used for showing the result. Here you can see Urkund has scanned this many document in this example. So the green shows that it is 0%. Plagiarism content is nil in that zero. But anything between 0 up to 20, 25, it will be marked as yellow. Little more color orange, turning to orange is 21, then dark orange is 27. And up to 75, if you look at 47, 70, all this belongs to the group of red color. And finally, if it is fully copied, it will show the black color in that. This could be full, this can be showed as full copied. The reason that either intentionally copied, otherwise your own document is already submitted to Urkund archive. Then also you can get this 100%. Anything here. Then this is how it is. And the report will have, as here you see, this is the first panel dashboard. This is the second panel in report. This is the third panel. Now, this first panel, you will see the document name and Urkund ID. If university is very keen, they can ask for this ID, so that all documents submitted in Urkund will be referred by an ID, then time and date of submission, then who is the student, the researcher who submitted it, and where it has gone to, this person has submitted to them himself. So that is why supervisor and email ID both are same. Otherwise, student email ID and faculty email ID, that is the way. So this will go here. Once it is generated, it will show total percentage. So this is plagiarism in percentage, size in pages, then number of sources from where it is copied. And you will also have button like this, hide, quote, then this is the hide quote, then settings, show alternatives, and the next copied link. These are the link by link. This is what is available in first. This is what is this area I elaborated first one. And once this report is generated, 100, you can share the report. Either there is a button called share. So once you click on the share, it will ask whom it has to send. So I gave an email ID of the faculty where the report should go. And Urkund analysis report shows that 68%, this is a message they can read without any filtering. By excluding source of this, the percentage is come to 815. This is the report generated and shared by me when it is done. And what student will get, or a faculty, someone, possibly your teacher, has forwarded Urkund analysis to you. So the analysis shows that this is the why. Whatever comment test I made it, whatever test I made it, this is this all came in mail, plus there is a link. Oh, see that it's a long link. So only the user can able to get this link, and he can click on it. Then he just get the simple. It works. Now let me go and log into an original. I will use this and use Shodganga for that purpose. shodhganga@inflibnet.se.in. I have typed both name. Now I have checked two reports here. One is from here, one is here, and both reports results are shown. Now this is what I was telling, that I can, and this is another folder which I showed the report. So I can create folder, edit to folder. If I come to home Urkund, as I mentioned, click on the logo to get into the dashboard again, and here I click new folder and created. Here I one folder for ICNO I created just for showing. One ICNO student came to check some documents, so we have done it. Now look at the results. One is 10, 29, 39, 50, 55, and 82, and this is how the document is tested. Now I take one document to show that how the report look like. I take 39% this one, so I click on that. Where to click? Click on the percentage. Now it is taking to the full report format, panel 1, panel 2. Now this shows. So right now what you can do, right click, print this portion, because this should be your first page. How many pages are there, how many sources it is copied, what is the total percentage. So, and here you will see the copied content as a bar, the status of highest, longest bar shows. Here it will not show how much percentage from this. Instead of that, it shows that how much variation from each source. So I click on this. Now these are the portions copied. Portion in a sense, this is the full. Out of this 100% test, 93% is copied. Please do not mistake this percentage and this percentage. This shows for this link, out of one copied content, how much is copied. Sometimes you know, people rewrite the text. It is called paraphrasing in plagiarism. So you copy the content and change some words in between. So it is shown that out of this total paragraph, little editing is done. Still the copied content is 93%. So that is how. Now let us see that something which you want to really exclude. This portion is known to you. Now because you feel that you have already cited, it is your own article, then click on this. The percentage came down. This is how. Earlier it was 34, now 33. Now you take 2, 3, 28. But this is not allowed unless faculty or university agrees. Even if you are doing this kind of exclusion, a statement should be generated and give to the report. Then only report is complete. Many times we get this question, how to exclude one link. I have already cited. Excluding is simple. Check with your faculty and tell that this is already cited properly, so I exclude it. So that is excluded. So how much person can be excluded? That is to be decided by your faculty and the university. INFLIBNET Center or Urkund do not recommend any percentage of copied content in a document. It has to be left to the university and the supervisors or teachers. Now this report can be shared by using this. Click on this, share, and it will go. You can export this report in a PDF file. So later you can, I just export it. So it is generating the report and it is stored in a PDF file. Now look at the report. The report generated shows that this is the title, this is the date of submission, who submitted it, and finally some sources, 17 sources it is copied. These are the major sources. Now it will show that this source what is copied, this source what is copied. All this will be marked in separately. Here it will not show the total percentage in the report. For that you need to take again, disable alternative matches. If you find at the end you will see some alternative resources here, all this I disable it, so it will not appear in my report. Now go to second, third, fourth, use this to go to the next copied content. This way it's showing. Coming back. So I think I have finished telling you that how to analyze the report which is generated by Urkund. With this, I think I am through. Let me see how to upload a document. Submit a document to this. Let us. I am Shodganga as a researcher. We are submitting. INFLIB@analysis. Everybody will have an analysis account once you register faculty. Now, if it is correct, you can go to next step. Now, let me see if I make it wrong. It's typing something IN. Now, what is it? Please enter a valid address. So you need to get an address here, com. Then you can write the subject, what is to be checked. May you will, I suggest how to name it. You give your name, then the title of the chapter or document, then submitted by whom, on which data. This can be given there, or at least give the username and title together. Or in the same title, if it is thesis, you can give the title chapter 1, title chapter 2. So that can be used. Later also you can easily see that which document is your. Chapter 01. Now this is one way. A second, I will suggest that you go to the, suppose this is what is to be checked for you. Now take this as it is. I took it control C and paste it, so your mistake will not come if your chapter is named 01. This is how it is to be. Then some message. This is for plagiarism checking. You can draw, leave it also. Now I select one. This is how I named it. You look at this Hirel 1 chapter 1 development. So I select this. So accordingly I have to make it now. What I'll do, rename, control A, control C. Now, so that it will be easy for me to paste here. So see the chapter, I created it, and this is the first chapter of Hirel, and submitted it, open. Now, the document is shown here, number of bytes is given. You can remove it is mistaken. Remove all also is there, but I submit it, because I feel. Now, document send, please. Wait for final copy. Now, after submitting, you go to your email box and see that whether it is done. It will come here, email box. This document is submitted. Submitted. And you have to wait some more time to get the report. This is the document. This ID, I checked it. Now, if you click on this, it will show processing. That means document is submitted, but the plagiarism check is not completed. If it is completed, dashboard here, you will get the percentage. This is how it is done. Now this is a test document which we took to see that how plagiarism check went, all the name shown and title, etc. Everything is for dummy purpose. So it is not actual. By this way, it is easy to use Urkund. Sometimes, no. If you are submitting for first time to Urkund, your result or your invitation mail will go to the spam folder. So, if it is in spam, go to here, check your spam folder, click here. If there is any Urkund mail, accept it. Then next time onwards, you will get the mail. Now, this is how Urkund works.
You have seen how I used this Urkund website to submit the document and as well as getting the result from Urkund and analysis by looking at the dashboard which is created for a user or a submitter. Now from our side, Shodganga team request you to use this product extensively for your research purpose, for checking the plagiarized content in your articles, thesis, dissertation, etc. With this, I thank you for watching this and I wish you all the best for your research. Thank you.